This bootleg really tried its way to look like macOS Sonoma. And let's just say, let's jump into the installation. The installer uses Longhorn built 4053's Windows Pre-Installation Environment, or Windows PE. And what about the boot screen? Well, it's only the Windows XP logo, but in white. But...
Hello, I am Macintosh.
The hello text is here, and also the welcome screen has a time and date at the top. Nice little addition. Okay, straight into the desktop after a few preparation and dishery. Here is what they call Sonoma XP. The desktop looks macOS-ish with macOS Sonoma's default desktop background, the dock which uses Rocket Dock, and also the gadgets which are taken from Windows Vista along with its pre-installed gadgets. The upper bar which replaces the Windows taskbar with the macOS menu bar such as the clock, the Windows logo, as well as some options for the OS. It's kind of hit or miss for me. Taking a look at the launchpad, it's more lean to the OS X era style in my opinion. But I can be wrong, I'm not a macOS user, but if you are a macOS user, tell me in the comments down below. The launchpad itself has several system applications added to it, as well as the functional search feature. As for the theme, the Candy theme has been refined to make it as if it's finalized for Windows XP. It's, in my opinion, quite an attempt, and the rumors are correct. This Candy theme is actually mimicking Mac OS X's Aqua theme.
Hey there, I'm a Mac, and I am a PC.
Internet Explorer is not entirely replaced, but primarily replaced with MyPal Unstable version 68, which can access YouTube at least, well, decently. Unlike when you click the subscribe button below, which can be accessed easily so that I can reach 6,000 subscribers later. No pressure. MSN Messenger is also bundled in here, as it's apparently bundled with Escargo as a patch. The Windows version of FreeActor's Application Manager has been ported in here, along with its repository of applications. It's not complete, but it's getting built. You can install some applications such as VLC Media Player. But that's about the things that I found interesting in here. And now, let's talk about the roasting part. Each time I booted onto the desktop, the X launchpad window and HTTPS proxy window opened. The dark mode in this bootleg is kind of incomplete with the dark text in display properties. MSN Messenger isn't working because Escargo isn't installed. The toolbar at the top doesn't function as intended in some cases, as you have to skin it each time graphical changes occur. Very bothering. And minimizing apps is, well, yeah.
Bro, I'm stuck. Can you help me?
Other than that changes, well, this is basically just Windows XP slapped with macOS stuff in it. I mean, SaragaWin555 did quite a great job at mocking macOS Sonoma because, well, Blizz is actually taken in Sonoma County. And also, the background is kind of sussy Sunset Blizz background. So, yeah, I don't know. I don't have much of any other words to say on this bootleg. Do you want to try this? Well, I'll put the link in the description if you want to download it. And you can check out the Windows Customization Hub Discord server for more mods like these, and bootlegs like these. Also, be sure to join my Discord server, both links are in the description. If you know what this is and you're firmly sure that this is what you think, then check out this video. Meanwhile, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for my support and for making this video possible, and also don't forget to check out this video.